हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास टुडे. सो टुडे आई वांट टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एपिडर्मिस, आल्सो द सिंपल एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यूज. आई इन द लास्ट क्लास आई हैव डिस्कस्ड विद यू दीज कोलेनकाइमा, पेरेनकाइमा, स्कैरेनकाइमा. दीज आर द सिंपल परमानेंट टिश्यू एंड आई गेव यू अ डिफ्रेंसिएशन बिटवीन दीज थ्री. एंड ऑल्सो आई डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एरेनकाइमा एंड कोलेनकाइमा ऑल्सो. So let's start with the epidermis. Epidermis is what? Epidermis is the outermost layer of the cell and it covers the entire plant, and it is a thin layer of single cell but in places with less water. The epidermis of the plants can become thick in order to avoid frequent water loss. So epidermis kya karta hai? It help in preventing the water loss. Also it contain very less water. The cells are very flat and they have no intercellular space between them. The outer walls of the epidermal cells are thick and inner wall is thin. So the epidermal cell often have a long hair like structure in roots that can facilitate in the absorption of water. So these epidermal cells also helps in the absorption of water. Also there are many function of epidermis, that is to protect the fungi from a water loss and any injury by secrete a wax like water resistant substance called cuticle. So on the surface of the plant, which protect it protect the surface of the plant. So here is a structure given here. It is given in your NCRT also, you can study from that also. This is cuticle. This is pellucid parenchyma. This is spongy parenchyma in the center. I have discussed this in the previous class, but I want to discuss this again so that it must be clear to all of you. Here it is lower epidermis. Here it is upper epidermis. Upper epidermis ke just above cuticle present hai. ये पूरी सेल्स क्या है? मीजोफिल सेल्स हैं. इन मीजोफिल सेल्स में पैलेसाइड पैरेन्काइमा एंड स्पॉन्जी पैरेन्काइमा इज प्रेजेंट. Here you can say, here you can see that the stomata is present. Stomata have two guard cells that helps in the exchange of gases, that is carbon dioxide and oxygen. So what is stomata? Stomata is a pore like structure that are present in the epidermis of the leaves, and these pores are enclosed by two cells that have the similar shape like kidney. These are called as guard cell of the stomata, and the guard cell are modified epidermis cells. So guard cell are responsible for exchange of gases and also the transpiration. Transpiration is what? The loss of water from the leaves of the plant. So let's discuss the transpiration now. So this is the structure that explain the transpiration in plant. The plant cell, which when sometime have extra water, they lose it in the form of water, evaporate through the stomata. कभी कभी क्या होता है, ज़्यादा absorption, water का ज़्यादा absorption होने के वजह से तो plant क्या हो जाता है, plant के पास excess water हो जाता है. तो वो water कहाँ से lose होता है? By the process of transpiration, and this process is known as the transpiration. Here you can see water is absorbed by the root hairs, and then by the capillary action and succession pressure, it will go to the stem and it will ultimately go to the leaves. So the excess water is lost from the leaves. So here the role of transpiration in plants. So exchange of gases is transpiration help in the exchange of gases, because plant absorb carbon dioxide and releases the oxygen, which is very important for our environment. It prevents the plant from overheating. The leaves absorb the sunlight during the process of photosynthesis. Some of it is used in the photosynthesis process, while some rest radiated as heat energy. We know that the absorption of water causes cooling of the surrounding area. So whenever the transpiration occur, there is some cooling effect occur in the leaves. So this is also help in preventing the overheating. Now next is transportation of food and water in the plants. The root of the plants absorb the mineral, and water present in the soil through the transpiration, and they are distributed in the plant through the process of transpiration. So whatever the water and minerals are absorbed in the soil by the roots, these are distributed in the plants through the process of transpiration. So last function of transpiration is what? Movement of water in the plant. As a plant lost water in the form of water vapors, the density of the water in leaves become low. So the water from the higher density area such as root move up to the lower density area, and this is called as the transpiration pull. So this transpiration process help in the movement of water. So let's discuss some question. Which gas is necessary for the process of transpiration? The carbon dioxide gas is necessary for the process of transpiration. Plant use carbon dioxide along with water and sunlight to produce glucose in the process of photosynthesis. These all question I have discussed, but I want to discuss again so that it must be clear to all of you. Plants take in carbon dioxide and releases the oxygen as a byproduct during the photosynthesis. Why do plants in desert areas have a waxy coating of cutin? Because so that there must be water, it prevent the water loss from the plant's surface. So that's why the desert area plants have a waxy coating of cutin over them. So these are the questions. Next is the, let's start the new topic, that is complex permanent tissue. So what are complex permanent tissue? These are comprises of different kinds of cells, and these different type of cells coordinate with each other and perform a common function, that is called as a tissue. The two complex permanent tissues are xylem and phloem. Here the structure of xylem is given, here the structure of phloem is given. It is also given in the NCERT, you can refer to that also. So what are the similarity between xylem and phloem? Their main function is to carry, xylem ka main function, phloem ka main function kya hai? To carry the food, and xylem ka function kya hai? To carry the water and minerals throughout the plants. Both have a vascular bundle which is conductive tissue in plants, and that help the plant to survive in different environmental condition. So these are the structure, the tracheids, fibers, perforation plates, the companion cells in the phloem, sieve tubes, fiber, sieve areas and the sieve elements. So what is xylem? Xylem is a dead cells having a thick cell lining. It consists of following elements: tracheids and vessels, xylem parenchyma, xylem fiber, that's it. So what are tracheids and vessels? They have a broad tubular structure so that we can allow the transportation of food and water in the plant vertically. So the xylem parenchyma is what? It stores the food and help in the transportation of water horizontally in the plants. Xylem fiber is what? They support the transportation. So these are the structure given here, the xylem fiber, tracheids and also the xylem vessels. Next is phloem. The phloem is made up of living cells and it allows the movement of food from the leaves to all parts of the plant. Xylem kya kar raha tha? It absorbs water and minerals and help in the transportation of water and minerals from root to all parts of the plants, and ultimately it will loss from the leaves. Phloem kya kar raha hai? Phloem mein opposite hota hai. Phloem mein jo food banta hai, food processing hoti hai, wo kahan hoti hai? Leaves mein hoti hai. We know that by the process of photosynthesis, and then this food goes to all parts of the plant. So it is made up of sieve tubes, companion cell, phloem fiber and phloem parenchyma. Sieve tubes are what? Broad shaped cells with porous walls. Companion cells are, they facilitate the functions of sieve tubes. Fibers, phloem fibers are what? It provide the flexibility to the phloem. And phloem parenchyma is what? Store the starch and proteins. These are the main functions of the part of phloem. So now the differences are, The xylem is made up of dead cell and phloem is made up of living cells. Xylem contain the cell wall thickness and phloem is cell wall is thin. The cell wall material in xylem is lignin, which is rigid, and in the phloem is it is made up of cellulose. Permeability is impermeable. Xylem do not allow the substances to go through it, but phloem is very much permeable. Cytoplasm is not present in the xylem, but it is present in the phloem. Xylem mein transportation kiska hota hai? Water and minerals ka, but phloem mein kiska hota hai? Food ka. Carried to the leaves, and phloem carried to the various organ or various parts of the plants. Direction of flow is upwards, because the direction when the water is absorbed from the root and it will go ultimately in the upward direction, but in the case of phloem it is opposite, it goes to downward direction, up and down both. So tissues are fibers, and tissues are here phloem mein companion cells. Now next is animal tissues. Animal tissues में आप, ये बहुत important topic है, आप देखेंगे animal tissues are made up of epithelial tissue, muscular tissue and nervous tissue. अब यहाँ पर देखेंगे आप muscular tissues में movement और locomotion में काम आता है. Movement function क्या है इसका muscular tissue का? Movement and locomotion. Locomotion means movement. So the muscular is again divided into three: striated, non-striated and cardiac. Next is connective tissue. Also animal tissue has a four parts, that is epithelial, muscular, connective and nervous tissue. Connective tissue mein aap dekh rahe honge areolar, adipose, fluid, blood, lymph, skeleton, supporting tendon and ligament, also the cartilage and bone. Epithelial cells mein squamous, ganglion, cubical, ciliated and columnar. Nervous tissue is helping in the control and coordination. Now start with the epithelial tissue. These are the protective tissue of the human body. They cover many organ and cavities that are present inside the body. Where are the epithelial tissues are found? They are found in the lining of blood vessels and the lining of the mouth. Also the kidney tubule, skin and the lung alveoli. Next is, what are the structures and functions? The main function of the epithelial tissue is what? To act as a barrier and separate the different organs and the system. Yes, different organs ko separate karta hai. And there is no space between the cells of epithelial tissue. They are very much permeable, and this makes it possible for exchanging the material between different parts of the body. Also between the body and the external environment. So epithelial tissues remain separated from the tissue beneath them because of the thin membrane over them. There are different type of epithelium: simple squamous, simple cuboidal, simple columnar, transitional, pseudo striated, stratified and stratified squamous, stratified cuboidal and pseudo stratified columnar. So these are the differences here I have given. The types of epithelium, you can see here the structure. Simple squamous is made up of, they are delicate cell lining and the and possesses a thin structure. In stratified squamous, the epithelium squamous cells are arranged in several layers. Here you can see. You can see here the stratified squamous are present in the form of different layers. Next is columnar. They are the column-like shaped tissues. Ciliated columnar, columnar epithelial tissue which have cilia present on them. These are ciliated columnar tissue. Next is cuboidal. They are cube-shaped cells which are involved in absorption and secretion. Glandular are, these are the special gland cells that can secrete the various substances. Simple squamous is found in alveoli and Bowman's capsule, which is present inside the kidney and also inside the nephron in the kidney. Nephron is present inside the kidney, that helps in the filtration of blood. Stratified squamous is present in skin. Columnar is present in intestine. Ciliated columnar is present in respiratory system. And cuboidal is present in kidney tubules. Last one is glandular. Glandular is present in sweat glands in the skin. This is very important. One function structure I have given, and also I have given where these type of tissues found in. Next is connective tissue. The structure and functions of connective tissue we are going to discuss. They are loosely bound cells present in the intercellular matrix. These matrix can be different type: dense, rigid, fluid, jelly-like, and the depending on the functionality of the connective tissue. Examples are blood. Blood is a type of connective tissue. We cannot say blood is a cell. Blood is a tissue that is made up of different cell. The main function of blood is transport gases, food, waste material, and hormones of the body. Therefore, the blood has the fluid matrix called as plasma. These plasma contain red blood cells, white blood cells, and the blood platelets. RBC has a function. It contains a hemoglobin pigment which carries the oxygen to tissue. White blood cells fight against the disease, and platelets are involved in the clotting of blood when injured. Plasma contains the proteins and also the hormones in it. Now, lymph. Lymph is what? Lymph is a colorless fluid that carries white blood cells throughout the human body. These are the lymphoid organ present in the body, and that produce the lymph and together form a lymphatic system. So some of the lymphs, example of lymph are lymph nodes, tonsils, and also you can say thymus, spleen. These all are the example of the organ which are present in our body. And these help in the fighting. Here you can found that the different type of cells are present, and also these cells are help in fighting the against the diseases. But lymph is made up of what? Example of lymph are lymph nodes and tonsil only. Okay, and these are the colorless fluid that carries white blood cells and which help in the fighting of particular diseases. Now, lymph capillaries in the tissue space, you can see here the tissue cells, tissue space, venules, lymphatic vessels, lymph capillary, arterioles, and the tissue fluid. So, lymph is similar to the blood except few differences we can discuss here. It contains only the white blood cells, but blood contains all type RBC, WBC, platelets, also the plasma. But it contain only the white blood cells. Next is it contain less amount of blood, protein, calcium, phosphorus, but more glucose. यहाँ पर glucose ज़्यादा मिलेगा आपको. It flows in one direction only. Next is lymph move in the body through its normal function, unlike blood, and it is pumped by heart. The constituent of lymph are lymph plasma and lymph corpuscles. इतना आपकी बुक में नहीं दिया है, but still I want to discuss. Lymph plasma carries infection fighting proteins along with other substances such as water, calcium, and phosphorus. Lymph corpuscles are comprised of white blood cells, RBC, and platelets are not present in the leaf. तो the basic difference क्या है? Lymph plasma क्या carry करते हैं? Infection fighting proteins. ओके इसके इनके साथ साथ इनके पास वाटर भी होता है, कैल्शियम भी होता है, फॉस्फोरस भी होता है. बट लिम्फ कॉर्पस्क्यूल्स के पास क्या होता है? सिर्फ और सिर्फ वाइट ब्लड सेल्स होती हैं. रेड ब्लड सेल्स एंड प्लेटलेट्स आर नॉट प्रेजेंट इन द लिम्फ. फंक्शन क्या है लिम्फ का? इट कैरीज द ऑक्सीजन एंड मिनरल्स टू द सेल इन द बॉडी एंड कैरीज बैक कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड वेस्ट मटीरियल बैक इन टू द ब्लड. Also, it keeps the body cell moist. It maintains the volume of the blood it help in the eliminating harmful bacteria and virus from the body. That is responsible for the immunity, maintaining the immunity of human beings. Also, it absorbs the fat from the intestine and transport throughout the body. So these are the function of lymph. So I think this is it about your the class. I hope it must be clear. I have given a notes. I will provide you these notes after the chapter finishes. Read the NCRT thoroughly. The notes are prepared from the NCRT only, and the some extra lines and words I have taken from other sources. So I have prepared these notes only from the NCRT, and these are not that much. I think these are very very simple notes, and these are not very much complicated for you. But I would like to suggest you that please read the NCRT also. In the next class, we will study about the bones. Thank you. Have a nice day.